אוקיי.
בוקר טוב, good afternoon, good morning everyone around the world. Are you joining me? You have a mustache. תצלב אותה. זה מאוד מצחיק.
מוסטש חלב.
בוקר טוב, מי מצטרף אלינו לדג מרוקאי בכיף שלנו לקראת שבת? החלה כבר מוכנה. כן? Anybody is joining us?
נורין.
נורין, good morning. Where's daddy? Tell him to join us too. מי עוד?
שישה אנשים.
That you can count, you can read the names.
No, the names don't appear now.
Oh my goodness, maybe we will be alone.
Make some
of
this, I think you will love it.
Thank you, mustache girl. Maybe you're staying with us later? No? Okay. So who is joining us? Because we really want to start preparing a Moroccan fish. Greek version. Because I'm not Moroccan. But I will try my best to prepare for you the best Shabbat dinner that we eat during Friday. So I hope some of you will join us now, and maybe some of you will join us later. And I hope you survive the Passover, the Mimuna, and the Corona. Because we are in Corona days, so our mission is to make you all happy. So today I'm not going to demonstrate how to make the dough of the challah, because I think we have a live like this. Do we do?
Yeah.
Yes. So, I'm not sure it's on our YouTube,
yeah,
Mr. Photographer. So, Yotam, later on we can share the link. But we have a recipe in Hebrew and English for this beautiful challah bread. But because some of the people are asking, I will show you today how to braid the challah. Because we are going to cook the fish sauce, the tomato fish sauce, from scratch. So it might take some time, so we will have time to braid the challah. אז בוקר טוב לכולם, ורד הצטרפה אלינו, כי זה מקור בהשראתה.
לא, אבל אור גרבלי הצטרפה.
אור נורס דיסרסט.
מיכאל גרבלי.
כן, כן, מי אור?
רונית, גילי, סוזי.
Yes, סוזי from Japan.
חוזה, כן.
Is she going to make it today for Shabbat dinner?
We'll see, hopefully.
Okay, so anyone, if you have any question during the live, please follow me. We are going into the kitchen, I'll just show the ingredients. So to make my version, because every Israeli Jewish tribe person have a recipe, different recipes for this fish cooked in tomato sauce or spices sauce. I have many recipes. This one is from last week that I decided to do, and it was such a blast, such a success, so I decided to share it with you. First of all, in Singapore, somehow we can find tomatoes that are crushed in a can, or whole peeled tomatoes, or at least in the supermarkets where I live. So I started buying like 4 kg of tomatoes, and I started doing the tomato sauce from scratch, and I enjoy every moment, so I leave them outside. I don't put the tomatoes in the fridge. I wait until they become very red and sweet, and this is very good quality, surprisingly. I have here garlic, I have red fresh chili, and I use for this dish lots of coriander, or in America we call it cilantro. And I like it a lot. If you don't like it, maybe try celery or Chinese celery or parsley.
הנה סבא אבו.
Oh, סבא אבו הצטרף אלינו.
שלום סבא.
היי סבא, בגלל זה לא עניתי לך קודם. Okay, regarding the spices, I'm going to use, this is sweet paprika, because unfortunately I don't have spicy paprika. So Israeli friends, please help me. I have here turmeric, okay? This is fantastic for the Corona days. And I have here a bit tomato paste, a bit salt, and a bit sugar to balance the flavors. And later I will show you another trick. And the fish I'm using today is sea bass. Singapore friends, this is from Shian Song. How do you call it? 2 sea bass in $12. Quite nice price. You can use frozen fish. It's okay for this sauce. Today I went to the supermarket. I went with my gloves and my mask. So today we go fresh. So let's go to our small kitchen. Does anyone have any questions? Yotam.
No, no one is asking
Holly
yet.
Holly is not joining us for a clean and lean recipe.
Holly did not join
okay,
yet.
Okay, she can join us later. Everyone can follow us. Okay, so another trick that I have today, I learned from Vered, my friend, that shared with me
a
fantastic way. Ah, Angel is here with us. Angel, what we are making today is an Israeli version for Asam Padas, which is the Malay fish with the same ingredients, but with a bit acidity and laxative. So I'm doing today the Moroccan version. So here I have 1 tablespoon of paprika. I use different kinds of paprika. You can find it in every supermarket.
In Vered.
Oh, Vered igia. Toda rabba, Vered. And Vered taught me to take 1 tablespoon of sweet paprika, 1 tablespoon of spicy paprika, and put it in 1 cup of oil. And let it stand. It can stand for 1 hour, 2 hours, and 1 week. And then you have a very interesting taste of the paprika. So let's start. I will use for the beginning with some olive oil for the beginning, and I will start with frying my chilies and my garlic. I have here olive oil, which is not very Moroccan. You can use any vegetable oil that you want, but it doesn't have a strong flavor, so I will begin with it. And I will begin with frying some of my chilies. I don't chop them very well because Shiley is a big fan of my fish and she doesn't like it too chopped, too fine. And I'm going to fry the garlic, which I sliced. You can, of course, chop them finely. For this recipe, I decided not to add onions. I want really a natural flavor of my tomatoes. Yes, any questions? Okay, Charm, are you with us? Ine Adina, good morning Adina. Who else is joining me? Say good morning everybody. You can just leave us a message here as a comment if you want us to prepare for you some special dish. As I said again, I'm sure that all my Israeli friends have... Rahim is here, he brought Asam Padas, Israeli style, yes. Moroccan style, you're right, Rahim. This is what we are doing. Okay, so I don't want to burn my garlic. I'm frying a bit my chilies. And I will add a bit of this paprika. I want to fry a bit the spices. Okay. 1 minute. Let's look like this. I want them to start releasing their flavor. Wotam, what do you say?
Oh, wow.
I wish I had smoky or spicy paprika. And now I'm adding the tomatoes. So if you have fresh tomatoes, and it's not very expensive here in Singapore.
Boker tov, Adina.
Boker tov, Adina le'emat mechina le'shabbat. Okay, this recipe is with love from me to you. And now I'm reducing the fire. I don't want to burn the garlic, and I will let my tomatoes to cook and cook in the oil, in the garlic. I don't use onion for this one. Okay, already I have the flavor, and I haven't done nothing. Later, I will add some tomato paste. Okay, so my expert online wrote me a private message again to tell you that it's very, very important to release flavor by frying the paprika and the turmeric in the oil. So you see, I don't add yet water. I just enjoy the oil and the tomatoes. Okay, so let's wait for my Wow, what a smell, huh?
Amazing.
Okay, you know what I'll do? Because we are live, I will add a little bit of water. Just a little bit water.
Adina mechina dagim vechatzilim ve'agvaniot.
Why? I have eggplants, maybe I'll make them also.
Oh, today we have a lot of viewers.
Now, for the beginning of this, I would like to add some coriander. And later on, I will add some more. Don't forget, we are on live on Facebook.
Holy Mason.
Ah, Holy! Are you ready for our clean and lean dish for Moroccan fish? So if you want to make it cleaner and leaner, you can use, you can control the oil. Moroccan cuisine is use quite a bit of oil, but you can control it. I believe that the tomatoes will give the best flavor. Look how beautiful it is. I'm not using from canned with canned tomatoes. I want them.
Beret, תביא לי גם couscous. היא מכינה היום.
Oh, Beret is making the best couscous. One day Beret will come to Singapore and start teaching you all her secrets that I took from her. Let's see. Okay, so while it's cooking, let's go 1 minute back here. And I have here a piece of dough that was left from the challah. So a lot of people are afraid of working with yeast. So I will show you how to divide the dough to three parts, okay? And to make one, let's see, like this. How to make a nice dough for Shabbat. Even if you are not Jewish, I think that there is something very therapeutic and beautiful to work with dough every Friday, and the house will be full with good smell of baked bread. I won't tell you that today I went to the supermarket and to Paul and I bought some croissant, but I think that Jewish challah is something that it's difficult to find. So I'm very happy to share with you my recipe. Okay, wow, look at this. Okay, so I divided my dough to three, and I'm doing three strips. Okay, I'll try them to be, and I stick them here, and I start braiding them. Every mother knows how to make braids. So here we have one, okay, we have some left. Okay, our challah is ready, but she needs to rise more. 1 minute, I'll bring my brush.
Shabbat shalom, Tamar.
Wow. Okay, so I have here egg yolk. Some people like to add a bit sugar or a bit date syrup. Sometimes I add some coffee powder into the egg yolk, and then the challah bread will get a nice color. Someone told me something today about shaping the challah in a shape of a key for good luck, but I'm not a good shaper. Maybe this part. Do you know how to make a key shape?
I don't know how to make even this one, I cannot.
Okay, never mind. You're a good photographer. Let's go back to the kitchen. My tomatoes are almost ready. Okay. Yesterday I made pizza from this tomato sauce, and it was really, really nice without any spices. And okay, it will take a bit time.
Hello, Joseph.
So what I will do now, I will add one or two spoons of tomato paste, which will give me a bit sweetness, a bit sugar, and a bit salt to balance the flavor. And I'll tell you what we'll do. I should have cut the tomatoes, but I like this quarter shape, these wedges. Okay, our sauce is beautiful. Always balance the flavors between the salt and the sugar.
Wow, wow.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, today a lot of viewers.
Yes, I told you, because it's Friday and everyone is thinking, what can I cook for Shabbat dinner? And anyway, it's a nice week. Every day here is a weekend. Oh, you see, I told you, come. This is a very... So I'll tell you what we do. Because we are on live, 1 minute, I need a bit sugar here. Don't leave us, guys, it's worth the trouble, I tell you. I'm adding a bit sugar. I have a good flavor of spices. I will If you cut the tomatoes smaller, of course it will take less time. And I like things that are really, really fast. I don't have time. So I'm going to add my, I'm not waiting to have a smooth tomato paste. I want it roughly. Okay, so for the people that joined us, I have some sea bass here, fresh sea bass. I didn't have time to ask him to remove the skin. If you like the skin, you can leave. If you don't, it's okay. And using a fresh fish is always very, very good. In Singapore here, we have fantastic fresh fish from Southeast Asia. 1 minute, I'll reduce the fire. As you can see, I have a wok fire. Okay, and I will start burying or letting my fish swim in this beautiful sauce.
I don't think it swims anymore.
It's not, yeah. It swam once. Now, I don't mind that I have some of the skin of the tomatoes. Maybe later I will remove it. There is another nice way of removing the skin in advance by blanching the tomatoes in hot water. And because it's sea bass and it's a very thin fish, in 5 minutes or six, our fish will be ready. Now, I will add a bunch. Where is my coriander?
The garnish.
Okay, so look how generous I am. Now, there are people that add.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yummy, yummy.
Okay, so let's cover this. And ask everyone if they prefer more Israeli recipes or they prefer
more.
Yeah,
please tell
Asian
us, and then we'll do
recipes,
more live.
More Singapore hawker.
They can send us recommendations.
Yes, please. Let us know.
Please
why,
do.
Why. I would call it a shakshuka. Kind of a shakshuka with our fish on top of it. Let's organize a bit here. And if you will stay with us for 2 more minutes, I will show you how the dish looks in the middle, and I will send you to the fisherman to bring some more fish. Why?
Wow.
Okay. 2 more minutes. Okay, who is here with us? Ella Kon, Boker Tov, Adas Polak, Smadar, Meital, Rega, ani lo roa kol kach maher, Yotam, Dana Shani from Singapore, hello Joseph, הלו דביר, בוקר טוב לכולם, סבתא לא הצטרפה, הנה דודה אתי, טלי אל מליח, בוקר טוב לכולם. All is happy with our clean and lean dish. Now you know what I would add, but then it will become Italian. I would add some black olives. And if you want to keep it Moroccan, you can add some chickpea grains that are cooked already. Wow, it looks amazing.
תודה אלה.
מה אלה אומרת?
מדהים.
יפה, תסתכלו איזה יופי, באמת. I really want the chunks of the tomatoes to stay. And again, if I see a peel of this tomato, it's not a problem to remove it. But I want to enjoy the whole... what, יותם?
לא,
בטוח. ורד פנחס, בוקר טוב, ורד. בטוח יש דג של סבא מרסל בסגנון הזה, רק יווני. So many nice people are joining us today. I'm really, really excited. And you know what? In 2 minutes, we are ready to serve. And if not, kids, you're going to eat sashimi today. So I'm going to prepare our table. Yo.
Wow.
Is it time? Yummy. I need some salt.
I didn't know
here.
This is how you prepare it.
Yotam, you never join my kitchen. Thank God we have this corona. Yes. So you're joining my live sessions. Yotam, did you tell them about our YouTube channel? Please do some marketing work.
Okay.
Mommy has a YouTube channel. Yes, Yotam.
At Wok'n'Stroll.
At Wok'n'Stroll.
Please, everyone, go like and subscribe. We have all the lives we upload. We try to upload every live.
Yotam is trying to.
Onto the YouTube channel. So then if you missed it today, that's fine. You can check out yesterday's live and the one before that. Just click on the video and give us a like and a subscribe.
We are really asking them for this, and tell them now in Hebrew.
אז אנחנו בווקנסטרול פתחנו ערוץ יוטיוב, וכל לייב, אם פספסתם את הלייב של אתמול או את הלייב של שלשום, אנחנו מעלים אותו לשם. אז בכיף, 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 בבקשה, תעשו לנו סאבסקרייב ותעשו לנו לייקים.
כי מה אם אתה עושה אם לא?
וואי.
לא תקבל אוכל, אוקיי. I'm going to serve it like
this. בבקשה, זה בשבילי.
מה? בשבילי. בדיוק. אוקיי, יאללה. will go like this, and I promise it's cooked, the fish is cooked, the dish is amazing, and Singapore friends, it's really similar to
fish cooked.
You can see, but let's say it's 90% cooked.
Okay.
Okay, because we need to release people and send them. Okay, bring me this. Okay, you
want me to
help me?
Yeah.
Like, no, two hands, it's heavy.
It's okay.
אתה מסתדר? פה, 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 קבלת שבת, בבקשה. טראם!
וואו.
אוקיי, באמת צריך גם צוות הכנות פה. אוקיי, so let's play.
תודה רבה, אלה, מאוד מעריכים את זה.
חבר'ה, זה ממש ממש טעים. It's so delicious. So I really expect you to send me some photos. Okay, so for this plating, this is a metal plate that I bought at near Tekka Market in Singapore, and I love it so much. Okay, I feel authentic. Let's put some of our, it's like roasted tomato sauce. Yo. Here is my fish.
Wow.
Okay, with lots of sauce, yeah? Yotam, this is for you, my love.
Thank you.
Okay, you can see that the fish look.
בזכותך.
מי אמר? מה? כפרה על ורד. בחיי. ורד, כשאת באה, אני מפסיקה לבשל, דרך אגב.
בואי מהר.
Look, Yotam, look at the fish here. You see, it's already flaky. Really, 5 minutes work.
Wow.
Okay? The rest will be for the other family members.
שבת שלום, עדינה.
רגע, ורד מרוצה? מה היא אומרת? יש פה תת של ורד? היא מאשרת שתעשה איזה לב פה ככה.
עשתה. אה, נורין אומרת שהיא תבשל לסבא.
I want to see this. Okay, so here is my challah bread. מה, לחתוך אותה בסכין או ביד?
נראה לי אפשר לטבול.
נראה לי ככה. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are not at the clean and lean part because we have here our challah. And I have here my fish. And think about my dinner tonight, it won't survive until the dinner. With this tomato, 1 minute.
Wow.
It's boiling, but it's good, okay. I love it. And I tell you something again, this is the tomato thing. If you use fresh red tomato, your life will be better. Okay, so Shabbat Shalom, everybody.
Shabbat Shalom.
Yotam.
I think why we leave you to eat here.
Yeah, tell them to go because
okay.
Shock or something. Be careful.
Oh, wow.
Wow. Shabbat Shalom. תכף נשחרר לכם מתכון. We will release the menu, the recipe, and please follow us on YouTube.
Thank you very much. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.